Daniel Andrews has snubbed the opposition's effort to see him turfed from Parliament by not turning up to the debate. He's left the talking to his deputy, as the coalition was accused of taking campaign tips from Donald Trump. Stephanie Anderson explains.
The Premier wasn't hanging around to hear it, but that didn't stop the opposition leader from playing his most powerful card.
It gives me no joy, none at all, to move this motion of no confidence.
Fired up over hotel quarantine failures, the curfew and crippled businesses, Michael O'Brien delivered a spray.
What sort of man makes a captain's call to lock up 5 million Victorians in their homes without a basis for it?
If supported by a majority, the move could lead to dissolving a government, but clearly confident he has the numbers, Daniel Andrews left his deputy to run the defence.
Politics in the middle of a pandemic. The desperate final throes, the last gasp, a no confidence motion from a man who has lost the confidence of his own party room.
Declaring it also doesn't have their support, the Greens turned the tables.
We're seeing the rise of Trump-style politics being used by the Liberals, and I'd say to them, they need to seriously pull their head in.
The Coalition's effort to represent Victorians who've died from COVID with plastic flags falling flat for many.
I think it's tasteless.
A lot of Twitter teardrops were unhappy.
But with determination unwavering, Liberal MP David Davis is squaring up for another long shot, an amendment to the controversial omnibus bill that would outlaw our 5 kilometre travel restriction.
So we'll knock it out cold.
The person that we should take our health advice from when it comes to corona is the Chief Health Officer, certainly not Mr. David Davis, a failed former health minister.
Now, debate over that omnibus bill is continuing here at Parliament tonight, but we're not expecting David Davis to get the opportunity to put forward his change for another couple of hours. The Liberals would need to recruit an extra 9 MPs to see it successfully supported, so that's looking incredibly unlikely. Meanwhile, the government is becoming increasingly confident it can secure the crossbench support required to get that bill overall through the upper house a little later tonight. Pete?
Stephanie Anderson reporting.